All right. So, what is up, guys? It is Deity GG Xiphios Vescor here, the solo laner for Deity Gaming. Today we are doing our first in the series of critiquing people's plays. This is from CDish on Reddit, playing Hell Mid. So pretty much already straight off the bat, there's a problem with his build. It's a little bit off. Pretty much every single mid laner is going to be want to be building Soulstone, Purple Pot, and then Potions, which would be 3 health pots and 2 mana pots. The problem here is that he has multi-pots and mana pots, no health pots, and he has boots. So I'm going to predict now that the Vulcan is going to outpush the Hell because she doesn't have Purple Pot, assuming Vulcan goes the normal Purple Pot with Soulstone start and will most likely outclear Hell. But we'll see. Pretty standard start here. Kraken support's a little weird, but whatever, it can be done. Let's go back to the build screen, actually. Let's go back a little bit. Okay, standard starts out of everyone. Yep, very standard starts. Thanatos, I don't think he should have gotten sprint, but it doesn't matter. It's not a huge deal. So they've started attacking the camps. Okay, Kraken's tanking, that's good. Problem here, it's not your fault, it's the Kraken. He should have pulled that red buff back a little bit more so that he would get the XP from the back camps, because I believe he's out of range of the XP from backs right there. So he needs to pull them back further. I don't know if you would do it with him or whatever, but that's what he needs to do. Here, ooh, that was. Okay. Right there. You should have gone to the left side of the wave so that you didn't hit Vulcan, because when you hit Vulcan with your three, you procced all of, or you aggroed all of the minions onto you, which is gonna bring a lot of fucking unwanted damage to you, so you gotta be careful with that. The Vulcan didn't go Purple Pot, and I don't know if he got Soulstone, but you're lucky they didn't go Purple Pot, or else he would have gotten severely outpushed. At least most likely, depending on how good this Vulcan is. So here you. Okay, never mind. I was gonna say that you were aggressing a little bit too much when their jungler could rotate quickly, but you're okay. Thanatos giving up a first blood. What's new though? Okay, this is risky. You have no eyes on their jungler, and Vulcan just left lane. That was a really risky play right there. If I were you, I would have just hung back and wait for the minions to push up. Luckily, there was no consequences of that. Looks like Bastet took a while rotating, or maybe she's on mid camps. Here, you should be keeping up your Soul Stone, at least 2 or 3, maybe even 4 stacks of it in between waves so that you get the MP5. You don't just want to clear it with abilities, you definitely want that MP5 in between the waves. But it's not a big deal. You guys are doing mids. I don't know where that Bastet is. Maybe she's off farming something. I don't know what the fuck she'd be farming right now. Because mid wave plus camps are much more important. Tier's getting pretty big. Here, Thanatos didn't call out a gank, but whatever, that's not your fault. You look like you're doing fine right now. You probably should have let the minions push back a little bit more, because you're taking a lot of damage. Like, that's like half of your health. And, like, you do have healing, but It's like all of your manatees are healing. That was pretty good there, but after you missed that initial one because of her jump, you probably should have backed off. Because they could have turned that fight easily if she had jumped back in. See, now you're probably gonna die here. Oh, no, he missed his ult. Yeah, that was just, I don't know, it was alright. It ended up working out, but that was just really risky. So be careful doing stuff like that next time. Like, if you, as a general rule, if you aggress and it doesn't go well initially, you should just start backing off. Keeping up soulstone stacks, pretty good. Hopefully you guys are going to back camps here. Alright. Yep, you guys are doing good. Going to red, he should probably back after this, because he'll be able to get pen boots. No, it looks like you're gonna stay when you have no mana. That's really risky. You're low on mana, and you have enough gold to finish boots, you probably should have backed. Like, now you have no mana and you have no stacks of soulstone giving you mana. There you go. Okay, stay for the wave. I would have used the three there, but it's alright. You might die for just staying. Yeah. Probably should have backed off earlier. Because, like, if you're, like, low on mana like that, right? If you're low on mana, or have no mana, like, you have mana for one spell, and you have no eyes on their jungler and their mid, you should probably back off. Just as a general kind of thing. But well, I probably would have done the same thing, to be completely honest, but hindsight's 20/20, you know. An enemy has been slain. Yeah, a couple wards, there you go. Good stuff right there. Getting a mana pot. Good job. Your middle tower's under attack. God. Kabrakan's getting salty. Once again, just Hell's Clear is super risky. Like, there's not anything you can do to fix that. It's just like her three is just so risky. Because, like, if Bastet were to come cripple you, you'd be totally fucked. But that was actually a good juke right there. I can't tell if that's my curse.
Hello?
Oh, there we go. Okay. That's you. I thought that was someone calling me on curse.
Better.
It's awkward. Okay, he stole mids, I think. Let's go back. Let's see. Let's go back. Let's see who got mids.
Hello?
Okay.
Better. Okay,
yeah, he got both mids. So, in general, right there, you want to save your ability so that you can save the mid camps. I know I saw that you were trying to burst it down as soon as you saw him there, but that's really not a great idea unless you know how much damage that you're going to be doing at that level and you're very comfortable on that god and you know how much damage you're going to be doing. But that'll come with experience.
How much? Yeah, look.
You should be splitting that with your jungler. Split everything with your jungler. You don't lose any gold because of Bumbas. And it just gets your entire team ahead. But that was mainly the jungler's fault, but you could have held it or waited. Or stayed in mid with him to help gank, but that was more of a situational thing than like a general kind of play improving thing. Okay, Bastet jumps on you, use the 3. Okay. Let's go back, right? So Bastet's on half health. She jumps on you, right? Instantly hit her with the 2, or you hit her with the 1. Hit her with the 3. Look at that. One or two autos would have finished her off right there. Look at how much damage she's taking from the minions. Look at that. That was mainly a reaction time thing, and that'll come with more practice playing the game more often. So if you improve your reaction time, you'll be able to find kills like that. Yeah, and she's gonna get out. That's a shame. Back off the X-Ball ult. Good, good. I would have used my beads there. Since you got hit with the X-Ball ult. Let's see, what are you going into? Dynasty Plate Helm, that's good. That's good. One of the bad things about this is that Hell's just not very good. You need CDR, and you need to be tanky, and you need magical protections, or magical power. And that's really hard to get on in one build, to get power protections and CDR. Season 2 was a lot easier to do that, especially because she didn't need as much power because of the way that her 3 scaled. I kind of like the aggression right now, because you have eyes on the Bastet, and you have started getting more power, and you finished your pen boots, so I like the aggression right now. I would have put that ward right there, but since you have a ward in duo right there, that's fine. Good job splitting camps. Looks like Thanatos wants to go in on Bastet there. Oh, never mind. I thought he was. He should have waited for you to split the fire camps. That's not your fault. If I were you, I would have gone to right lane to help your duo lane. Because it looks like they're going to get fucked on. Yeah. I would have helped them out. It probably would have been the better choice, since you really weren't likely to find anything on that Bastet. Yeah. Okay. You're gonna lose tower because of that. You took way too much poke and ate the Vulcanel as well. A lot of this is just positioning, is what I'm noticing. Just kind of like pathing, positioning, and a little bit of decision making. Not so much, but just a little bit. It's mainly positioning.
Dark Souls. Now you will know
pain. It was a good idea to put a sentry there. Should get out of the range. Yeah, there you go. Good shit, good shit. Yeah, just back off. Let the minions get closer to you, since you have no tower. Good job poking and while clearing, since now that you can full clear the wave, you won't take damage from the minions. Get the slow, the damage. Oof, this is good, this is good. Nice. Good D ward again. I don't know why they warded that again. Obviously have a sentry there. You should be splitting camps with your jungler. That's another thing. So positioning, splitting camps, decision making. Also, this is more of a preference thing, but I like putting points into Hell's ultimate because that gives her power and her dark stance and MP5 in her light stance. You don't have to, but that's just like, I like Hell. And that's just how I build her when I play. Which actually, it's been a really long time since I've played Hell. This is a really risky back. Really sketchy, but whatever. It's all good. What are you gonna go into here? What's the option? What's the choice? Alright. We have to wait. We'll wait and see. Your team's doing a really good job right now. The Thanatos looks like he's kind of new to jungling because he's not really splitting anything with you. Duo lane's a little far behind. Hopefully, yeah, you're gonna go help him out. Please go around from the back. There you go. There you go. Help him out. Give him some sustain and mana. If you didn't know, Hell's, if you put points into her ultimate, her light stance has a MP5 aura. You should split that camp with Thanatos.
No problem.
It's looking good right now. Pathing into lane like that's usually risky, but you have ward, so you should be fine. Good missing call. Jab helping your team out there. I don't know why Thanatos isn't going in. Fucking Bologna needs his help, what the hell? Ooh. Oh. Rest in peace, Bluestone. Oh, you guys are just eating ultimates. You stayed way too long there. Okay. As soon as you saw Bastet rotate in, let's go back. So, Thanatos dies, it's a 2v1, and he's really low, right? So, goes in there, Bastet shows up on the ward. At this point, you need to get the fuck out, because you're on 400 mana, which is just enough mana for a few abilities, and if she drops cats on you, you're totally fucked. At this point, you really should have backed out, but I can understand like why you would want the shutdown gold from the tier. Plus to help out the Bologna, plus just getting a kill in general. But with their team coming in like that, you really should have backed off. Especially because you also see Vulcan right there on the ward. I just pointed at my screen. You see Vulcan right there. At that point, it's already too late. But, I mean, you had the wards, you should have backed off there.
How's it going?
That was a good CC immunity, but... it was too late. Oof. You might have been able to turn and use your one there, but it would be risky. Don't go book. Go shard. Don't do it. Ah, okay. So. Stacking is out of the meta. Transcendence, Book of Thoth, somewhat Devos, just in general. Warlocks as well. Stacking is not in the meta right now. Fights are happening much earlier. Stacking is expensive and it delays your build. Penetration right now is highly valued, so Obsidian Shard, providing power and penetration, you really fucking need that. Kraken's getting salty even though you're 1k behind, not even that much. I love the salty pings. God. Okay, once again, splitting camps. He should have gone with him to speed, with him to backs. Again, midwave here. Midwave. You're also ganking when you have no vision of their enemy team. With X-Ball ult. And your Thanatos is not with you, so this is really risky. Good job killing cats for Hoyi, though. You're welcome. I don't know why Hoyu is staying. He's good now. Oof, that... Wow. What an ult. Okay, so I'll take a Bracken. I don't know what you guys are doing. You guys can be shitting on him right now. Oof. Good job healing. Ooh, that was good. That was good. Throw out some TC immunity there. Okay. So this is, like, really sloppy, right? And it's not entirely your fault. In fact, most of it's not your fault. This fight was just really sloppy. You're all focusing different targets. You want to know how I know that, even though I had no vision? Look. Back a few seconds ago. Right back here. Everyone has different levels of health. Vulcan? Goomba. You guys all have different levels of health. That's why I know people are focusing different targets. Otherwise, one person would be dead, the other person would be low, or the other person would be like full health. You guys need to focus the right targets. You should not be focusing Goomba. See, this is good though, because everyone went on Vulcan there. You guys turn it around real quick. Because you're overstaying a little bit, because you don't have eyes on Bastet. Yeah, there she is. She's gonna kill him. Need to get the heal. There you go. What the fuck is Kraken doing? Bastet's gonna come in here and get a fucking triple kill. Yeah, there it is. You guys really overstayed there. Really overstayed. Like, Bastet came in from the side. At that point, you guys should just run down lane. More wards, I like it. Another reason why you shouldn't be going book is because you guys are really far behind and it's just delaying your build more because it's really expensive.
Pretty good. Are you playing ranked right now?
No. You're pathing somewhere with no vision. Oof, that's so risky. You guys should be ganking right now. But mid works. Ooh. If he hit that Fearless, you'd be dead. Actually, this Bastet might kill you. Looks like she will. Okay. Good Aegis. Okay. Alright, that was played pretty well, but you should have Aegis'd earlier, beads the slow, and healed. Basically do whatever you can to stay alive, because that Bastet's pretty big. So if you can deny that Bastet any more gold, that's really good. Yeah, like, look at her. She's fucking 6-1. Like, if you have to use both your actives and your entire kit on no mana, fucking do it. Don't let that Bastet get any more fed. Your middle tower is under attack. An ally has been slain. Okay. A lot of this is also a mechanical skill. But, okay, you should be leveling your ult before you two. But, it doesn't really matter. It's like, it's not a huge difference. Like I was saying, a mechanical skill. Like, knowing when to, you know, turn and fight, when to, kind of look for like an outplay, look for something. A lot of it's just mechanical skill that you'll get basically just by playing more. It's not like you're like misplaying mechanically, it's just that you're not playing perfectly, which I wouldn't really expect to be you to be playing perfectly, especially considering like you sent this video to get like critiqued or whatever. I wouldn't expect perfect play. So yeah, you're doing fine. You just gotta watch positioning. Positioning and then the build. And then like right there, like sitting in shop when you have no eyes on anyone in mid lane, and like your map is fully covered up. Oof. That's risky. You're all alone there as well. They could have gone on you. Like, if Bass had jumped on you and dropped cats and slowed you, you would have been dead. Or if Vulcan knocked you up. Okay, good job not running up to the wave and using your three. I probably would have cringed. Okay. I like that you're going left to help out the Bologna. I'm not sure why you tried to do the cleanse over the wall, because she was ulting, and that might have killed her. Like, if she dies here, that might have been your fault, because you didn't come a little bit earlier. But why would she walk into the turret? Oof. Yeah, that was just a weird. That was just weird decision making. It's alright, though. At this point in this game, I would have half of your team muted. Like, your team is fucking psycho. Thanatos and the Kabrakan are giving me AIDS. Good job leashing that, because Vulcan was right there. You probably should have had help from Ho-Yi. Could have asked him to rotate over. Not sure if he would have, though. Like, here, I would be asking for help. Like, even though he is coming. Holy fuck. He just got absolutely deleted. Yeah, okay, look at this. If you're gonna stack, you need to do it before 15 minutes. Like, that's like the cutoff, is like 15 minutes. After then, it's not worth it. But I don't know. Overall, just Book of Thoth just isn't that good. It gives a lot of power, but it really delays your build. Because it's just so expensive for a relatively low turnout, I guess. Oof. Stop it. Get some pen. Get some power in there. You need more pen. That's why you're not doing much damage, just because you don't have much pen. You got like, what, 35 pen? 25? I don't know. I don't know how much pen that is, but you need more pen. You need to get Obsidian Shard, because Obsidian Shard is 70 power and 33% pen. So that bypass is like a third of their shit, which is really nice. I'm liking your friends list. I've seen Tide Time and Loki Plague. So, you have a S plus to your friends list. Okay, this is risky. Like, if that area right there was warded, Bastet could have jumped over and killed you. Thanatos is salty arguing with your team, which they should all have each other muted. There's no point. No point in going left, like, you're not gonna kill the tier, especially if you don't have any pen. Like, that tier's huge. Bologna's really far behind, you have no pen. Yeah, good job backing off, though. Would've been a, really risky call. Okay, ooh, god. Okay, good job backing off, though, as soon as you saw Bastet, that was a really good play. Looks like your hoagie is going balls deep. At this point, like, yeah, they misplayed, but at the same time, like, you should have recognized that they were gonna be dumbasses and go in. Like, as soon as you saw, like, Hoagie, like, jumping over that fucking wall right there like a dumbass, you probably should have gone with him, just because it's better that the entire team follow the wrong call than everyone, half the team doing the right call and half the team doing the wrong call. Just as a rule of thumb. Just always help your team, even if they're being stupid. Unless it's, like, a blatant suicide mission, you need to help your team. Here, you guys are just fighting tanks. You have no pen, Thanatos doesn't have any damage, Bologna's really far behind. There's no point for you guys to be fighting the two tanks right now. Yeah. This was honestly, this is a really bad fight for you guys. Luckily, that X-Ball is just really far out of position. You're out of mana here, you could probably die. There's no point to be fighting this, like, there's nothing that you guys are fighting over. Like, this fight is drawn out so long that even if you kill Kumba and Tyr, their entire time would be up. There's no point to be fighting there. There's nothing to be gained. But, like, again, like, that'll come with more experience, really. You'll get there. I'm tired as hell. Please buy Obsidian Shard. I think if you're getting Rod, you get it. You'd go Pen Boots, Plate Helm, Obsidian Shard. Then you could go something like... I don't know. I don't really play Hell that much, to be completely honest. You could go, like... Ethereal Staff, maybe. That wouldn't be a bad pickup. Or you could go Breastplate of Valor, actually. That would be a really good pickup, because that would give you 20% CDR. Or you could go Chronos Pendant, depending. Either way, you're going to get a lot of CDR. Then that would be, what, your fourth item? Then you would go Rod of Asclepius, round out your healing, counter any anti-heal that they have. Then afterwards, finish your build off with a Rod of Tahuti. That would be my idea for the build. Because you definitely want the CDR. What the fuck, Thanatos? There's no reason to do that. Okay, you guys are gonna get fucked down by Tyr. That Tyr is absolutely huge right now. I think I should just be backing off. Yeah, you guys are outnumbered. Plus, you guys are all really far behind. You have to go back and teleporting in, which helps. Thanatos is going to miss his ult. Oh no, he didn't. That's a first. Good job focusing the Kumba when he was in his passive. That was a good immune as well. I think you immuned your whole team as well, which really helps. You should go with your team. Yeah. Go light stands. Yeah, there you go. You're all good. Heal him up. I don't think you recognize that that ult was there. I didn't even fucking see it until you died. Like, they're just Aegis, you know? Damn. How the fuck does Thanatos get a 26-minute triple kill? Good job getting that tower. Please build Pen. I think I might cry if your next item is an Obsidian Shard. Oh, thank God. Thank God. I probably would have cried a little bit. You generally really want to have Obsidian Shard as early as possible, but like after Dynasty Plate Helm and Pen Boots, then you get Obsidian. Because, like, look at your Book of Thoth. Like, you've had it for a while and it's only at 34 stacks because you guys have been fighting. Like, it was a pretty bad pickup, just because, like, look at how many kills are on the board. Like, there's 40 kills in 27 minutes. Like, that shows how much fucking fighting that's going on. So the Book of Thoth was a bad pickup. Oh. Good job. Why the f... What was that meditation? Jesus Christ. Whose med was that? That was pretty bad. You're also like, this isn't like about your plays, but like you're talking like once every like 30 seconds. Which is just kind of weird. Oh, sprint, okay. You guys should really have someone in left lane defending. I don't know what this Hoagie's doing, like he's just always off doing his own thing. If you had CC immune like just a second earlier. Which, that's just a mechanical thing. Not something that you can really fix overnight. He'll get there, don't worry about it. How the fuck did she miss that? I don't know what Kabrakan's doing either. Like, your team fights are, like, just so scrambled. Which isn't necessarily your fault. If you were a frontliner, that would be, but you're hell. So it's not your fault. At this point, I probably wouldn't even be helping Bologna, honestly. Like, it's a good thing that you are, but, like, my salty ass wouldn't be helping her. I would let her die. Just because she's playing stupidly. You also have really good ward coverage. Like, I'm saying that you're getting two wards every time you're back, which is really nice.
Be careful, middle. Just died. The boss.
Thanatos back camps? No? Okay. You help them with that speed. Get some gold in back. Get that obsidian shard. Good call, good call. Come on, get to Hoodie next. Ooh, this is really bad. You guys are super split up and you're way out of position. Okay, good job backing off though. That was good. So overall, you gotta work on positioning, I guess decision making, and then mechanical skill. For the most part, that's pretty much it. Mechanical skill and decision making both come with experience, though. The only thing that you can fix right now really is positioning. There's probably something else I can't think of right now, but I'm exhausted, I'm tired, so that was really good. Who the fuck pops sprint there? This has got to be like pre-30, like the random meditations and sprints. Holy fuck, that was a nuke. Alright, good job focusing the same target. Giving them a speed buff. Tier is split pushing, which no one should be backing for. You guys could literally take two Phoenixes off of a Deicide. You guys could actually take a Phoenix and Fire, or two Phoenixes right now. Or just Fire. I would have let Tier split push, like it's a fucking Tier. Like, what's he gonna do? That Kabrakan should be zoning. There's no reason for him to come back in. He needs to be zoning. That's not your fault, though. Good job. You guys should get out. Thanatos should not be there right now. Their entire team is up. Retreat. Don't do it. There you go. Good job. Is this game over soon? I'm fucking tired. Okay, yeah. We're almost done. Jesus, dude. You just fucking smacked back camps with a 670 damage nuke. Take it easy, man. Jesus. Hell does so much damage. You should probably just take it. Bologna has no mana troubles late game. The only warrior that really has mana troubles late game is Guan Yu. Plus your ADC should be taking red buff late game, always. The cheeky cleanse, I like it. You're really lucky that their team doesn't have like a Brawler's Beat Stick, a Pestilence, and a Curse. Or else you'd be totally fucked. Like, I don't know if this is low elo or if this is like pre-30, because like no one is counter building you. Like they have one Divine Ruin. You guys are all focusing different targets. You guys are focusing their tanks as well. Like their tanks are the ones that are low in this fight. You're chasing Tier. Okay, good job backing off, but the fucking Bastet split pushing. Bastet split push is no joke. Okay, Hoyi, I see you. Good job. Your Bologna should have been the one to back. If anyone split pushes, it should be the warrior that backs. That's like their job. Like your ADC is all your tower damage. There should be no reason that they be the one that back. You guys should be able to take the Phoenix. Keep pushing, keep pushing. Get his ass. Just come on, switch stances. Oh, he's done. Oh, I think he got Mantle of Discord there. What the fuck was that? Random stun. Get that Phoenix. Focus the Phoenix, boys. You guys are gonna get the mid-Phoenix as well. You could end off this, maybe. Yeah, you could end off this. You guys are actually really far ahead now. You actually, like, turned the lead in your favor really well. And that's something a lot of people struggle with, is, like, coming back from being really far behind like you guys were. And you've done it perfectly. You just ate that fucking Vulcan ult when you had Aegis. That was just a misplay. Like, look at that, your Aegis and your beads are up, and they have not been used in forever. It ended up not mattering, but that's just little things like that, you know?
What's up, dude? I'm about to win my boss fight, so...
Your friend is shitting on someone in Dark Souls, which is nice.
Got him! Praise the sun!
Praise the sun that you fucking pulled that game back.
That was pretty...
That's good.
Pretty hard.
Alright.
Got it.
Let's see, are you gonna go to the build screen? This is not pre-30, okay. Well, the enemy team had no idea how to play against a hell. Look. I'm gonna lay down some shit right now. If you are a jungler, and they have an immobile mage in mid lane like hell, get brawlers to kill their healing and gank the fuck out of them. Like, you went like what? 0-5 laning, maybe? I don't know, something like that. You were pretty far behind laning. A good jungler, you would have been like 0-10. Like, you would have been so much further behind if that jungler knew how to jungle. Like, if you're a jungler or a support or a mid laner, you need to be fucking that hell up. Immobile mages are not good right now. Look at the top picks. Giannis. Scylla, Raijin, Isis. The only reason Isis is viable is because she has four abilities that peel for her. Four. Alright. Builds. Oh. Go back. Come on. Go back. There we go. Okay, builds. This is not builds. Where's builds? Where's builds? I want to see builds. Where's builds? No, no. Oh, almost. Alright, builds. Come on, builds. There we go. Okay. Thanatos. That's a decent build. He's got pen, he's got power, he's got protections. I like it. Only thing I would switch out is Bloodforge because he doesn't need it. Hoagie has a bad build. He should not have Rage. That should be a Deathbringer or a Wind Demon. Kabrakan, good build. Bologna, good build. But she should not be getting Stone Cutting Sword. She should be getting Titans or something. Also, you guys had three sprints. Why? Why would you need three sprints? You also don't need two teleports, you need one. But I guess, okay, two teleports works just because Bastet, heavy split push. Wait a second, is that Bastet with Shield of Regrowth? Ugh. What the fuck? She doesn't even have any healing. Whatever, dude. Okay, they did have a lot of anti-heal, they just weren't targeting you. That's weird. X-Ball had an atrocious build. Jesus Christ, that Shibulanke build. Four meditations. What the fuck? They even had a pestilence. Yeah, I don't know why, but your heals still healed for a shit ton. Alright. So, positioning, decision making, mechanical skill, building. All of that will come with experience. Good luck, dude. I can see you being a good player.